This semester, my team and I have been working on an eight-legged robot called the Octoroach, which was developed here at the Biomimetic Lab at Berkeley. And the robot is meant for search and rescue operations, and we are helping the robot learn to walk.
So we're forming an integrated hardware and software solution for mobile diabetic maintenance care. What that means is that we're forming both a mobile app that goes onto a smartphone, which has all the features out there right now, plus a predictive layer that goes on top of that, that can forecast the glucose level of diabetics.
So the project we are working on this semester is crowdsourced rotoscoping. Rotoscoping is a technique in which you try to separate a foreground element from background and composite it on a different mat. So we're trying to see if we can crowdsource this particular technique and take advantage of the workers online all over the internet, all over the globe, to do this task for us.
The Masters of Engineering is intended for someone who's going to stay technical, at least for the conceivable future. They want to be more effective as a technical leader, though. And so they can hack the engineering, but they can also communicate why it needs to be done and manage people to get there.
It's not only about furthering the knowledge in the discipline, but it's about applying the disciplines to problems. Our capstone projects are parallels of this idea. We also run projects with our industry partners, and in one of our professional programs, we had an executive level team work on an industry strategy project with us. It was people at Cisco, at Network Appliances, at Applied Materials. They basically started to focus in on blood glucose monitors as a type of device which we could see becoming more intelligent.
Exactly, so as you can see, yeah, you get to see the differences in the resistance.
That's cool. It really works. That's nice.
The reason I was attracted to this program originally is because I was really interested in kind of deepening my technical knowledge in my field while also still being ready to get a job after I graduated.
And the thing that this program offered was further advancement in a technical field that I didn't know too much about, and then I complemented that with, you know, specific things like leadership programs and learning how to analyze markets in order to extract the important insights.
I think being a computer science graduate, you want to be in Silicon Valley, and if you're in Silicon Valley, it never gets better than UC Berkeley.
Well, how do you become what I call a better connected engineer? Connected not in the technology sense, but in really in a more societal sense. Whether it is connected to the idea, to the business, to the people, to society.
If your true skills and interests lie in the purely technical, that's the direction you can go in. If you want to have an impact on society, though, and have a technical impact, then you want the Masters of Engineering.
If it's not connected to the society at large or problems at large, then we're not solving anything.
I think Cal, as a world-class engineering school, is in a fantastic place to take that leadership role, and it's a huge opportunity.
These extra skills will make you more effective in any of those jobs that you would have had the opportunity to go into, and that's what's going to make the career difference 5 to 10 years from now.
And I think that is going to be exciting, and I hope the sort of the engineering leadership element will become even more critical, almost like the catalyst or the gel that's going to pull all this together.